All right. So I'm Justin Grinnell. I am the director of the USD Jazz Ensemble, and we're going to perform about six pieces for you. We actually do have a little surprise for you, so it's seven. I guess I'm giving it away now. But just to remind everybody, the USD Jazz Ensemble is a class that you can take here at USD, and we take all the instruments, and we encourage people of all instruments and all ability levels to check out the class. The goal, of course, is to play jazz repertoire, but also to work on that very scary musical skill, improvisation, right? But we're going to do a lot of that here, and I think you're going to see that once students spend a little bit of time in jazz ensemble, they get pretty comfortable just making stuff up on the spot. One of the other things that I hope to get from you all, yes, from you all, is, you know, some enthusiasm, some excitement. You know, if you hear a solo that you like, you can say woo. You can clap, you can, you know, but not sarcastically. None of that sarcastic stuff, okay? Yeah, but just some nice enthusiasm. It helps us, you know, bring energy in the music back to you. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to start with an old tune called The Turnaround, written by an alto saxophonist named Ornette Coleman, and recorded back in 1959. But it's a fun tune. It's a blues.
Thank you. you're going to notice throughout the night that we're kind of switching up the ensembles and stuff. We had a lot of people in the ensemble this semester. We had 6 guitar players, 3 bass players, 4 drummers, vibraphone, piano, all sorts of fun stuff, and of course our front line here with our woodwinds and brass. So lots of different sounds. You know, we made a lot of noise this semester, right? Good noise though, right? Good noise. Kind of the inspiration behind the tunes that I picked for this concert are that they're kind of celebrating anniversaries. And you would only know that if you're a jazz nerd like me. I admit it. I am seeking help. No, I'm fine. But the turnaround, I said it was originally recorded in 1959, but there's actually a very famous recording by a saxophonist named Joshua Redman that he did in 1993 with Pat Metheny on guitar, amazing recording. And then this next tune we're gonna do is a very famous jazz standard written by Kenny Dorham called Blue Bossa. And this one is famously recorded back in 1963. So this one's celebrating its 60-year anniversary. This might be one of the, you know, top 5 jazz standards that every jazz musician learns. Hope you like it. It's kind of a mix between blues language and the bossa nova. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
or on Instagram. I post some stuff about the jazz ensemble at USD Jazz, which is at USD Jazz. One of the anniversaries that I posted about recently, maybe it was yesterday or the day before, was John Coltrane actually was aired on television back in 1963 playing three songs with his famous quartet. And one of the tunes they played was Afro Blue, which is a very famous tune written by Mongo Santa Maria, has Afro-Cuban rhythms, and we're going to do that one for you now, Afro Blue.
Thank you.
single time, so they keep them on their toes. All right. I have to admit, I did pick a lot of jazz from 1963. I don't know why, it's just one of my favorites. This next one was also famously recorded in 1963 by one of the most influential jazz trumpet players, Lee Morgan, who also wrote the tune. This is his classic tune, The Sidewinder.
Thank you.
we're going to change the gears for just one tune here. We're going to feature one of our applied music students. That means that you sign up to take private lessons while you're in an ensemble usually. We're going to feature Justin Kahn on the alto saxophone, accompanied by USD faculty, Rika Parker. And they're going to play all of these. Of it in 1983, and I think that was for me too. But anyways, Now the band is going to play this for me and you.
Thank you.
funk is the guy to go for. That one's got its own style, doesn't it? We're gonna do one more tune for you, maybe, if I didn't have a surprise tune for you, but one more, wink, wink. We're gonna do this tune called Chameleon. It was recorded in 1973, so 50 years ago. And this is one of those tunes that fits in multiple genres at the same time. Some people might call it jazz, some people might call it funk. I'll let you decide. Chameleon by Herbie Hancock.
Thank you.
I want to apologize that I didn't introduce everybody going on and off the stage. We have so many great players in this band. I hope you enjoyed listening to all of them. Yeah? Thank you. Thank you. They very much enjoyed your enthusiasm. I could tell it affected the way they all play, and they were excited to play for you. And I hope they're excited to play this one last quick tune. It'll be really short, really quick little thing. And but as you can tell, we got quite a cast up here. Are we ready? Ready to make some noise? All right, this is the USD Jazz Ensemble, last song, and then we're going to take a little intermission before we hear the USD Jazz Vocal Ensemble.
Thank you. La la la. La 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 la. Mic testing. Oh, we've got a lot of microphones to test. We're gonna test them right now. Starting with you.
We're gonna test
the
microphone. We're gonna test
them right now. She's also going to be here next year at the Oceanside Jazz Festival, which I am taking the ensemble to the Oceanside Jazz Festival next year. Her name is Lila Bialy. She's amazing. And we are going to do a song that was written by her and the arrangement is Will Clements. I'm going to get that right. Will Clements is the one who did the arrangement. So enjoy.
Thank you.
Jazz Festival, my good friend Matt Falker, who is a director there, he teaches piano and voice. He is a wonderful pianist, jazz pianist, also a wonderful singer. He's involved in vocal jazz all over the country, outside of the country. He has a publishing company. He's written arrangements. So he's actually written an arrangement to actually one of my tunes that I wrote, which is we're going to do now. This is called Never Want It Broken. And I'm going to sing with him. I hope you don't mind. Oh, we got technical difficulties here. My music stands breaking. Don't know why.
Tells why and ever.
These next couple songs, we have, I have a two applied music, watch your microphone. I have two applied music students, and so these next two songs are gonna be a feature from each one of them. The first one we're doing is from Monye, where's your name? And we're gonna do a song by an amazing, one of the most amazing musicians anywhere. Her name is Esperanza Spalding. She's one of the most fantastic bass players. She's absolutely incredible, and she's also an incredible vocalist. We're gonna do this song. If you have a chance to actually look her up on YouTube and see her playing this song, and singing and playing this incredible, difficult bass line that our bass player is gonna play, it's pretty incredible. So this is called I Know You Know.
Thank you.
Justin again. Justin, man. And so this is cool. This is my first semester. So Justin's been here, and he has this great ensemble that kept growing in vocals. And so we're like, we got to do something. And so this became an official class because, well, Justin's really cool.
But he can't sing.
Well, I beg to differ. Thank you. And, you know, it's great because our ensembles are right next to each other, so we can kind of work out getting some of these players to come over and practice. It's quite convenient, even though when we're trying to do a song like Never Wanted Broken, you're doing Chameleon, a little difficult sometimes, but we make it work. Want to thank all the USD Music Department faculty and everybody all the helpers who helped us set up and all that stuff. You have anything you want to say, Jason?
No.